hundreds of medical operations cancelled.
It's just a short-term measure.
In an attempt to stop the state's healthcare system crumbling under pressure.
There has been no massive tidal wave. There has been no massive flood of work. This is chronic underfunding and chronic malnourishment of the healthcare system.
For 30 days, non-urgent multi-day procedures won't go ahead because WA hospitals don't have beds for patients or the doctors and nurses needed to treat them.
This is not due to COVID. This is due to the lack of capacity in the system and the inability of the system to deal with the emergency department ramping.
And they should stop scaremongering. We have a great health system by world standards.
Since the McGowan government was elected in 2017, ambulance rampings increased year on year, this month peaking at a new record of more than 6,000 hours.
And we now have a health system which is on its knees.
The cancellations will affect all public hospitals in Perth, as well as Geraldton and Bunbury. Same-day elective surgeries will go ahead, but may be rescheduled based on hospital demand.
The system is working well, but it is under pressure at the moment.
Forget the spin. The McGowan Labor government have dropped the ball on managing our health system.
Labelled a band-aid solution by the union, it's concerned delaying elective surgeries now could actually increase pressure on hospital staff over time, especially if WA was to have a COVID outbreak.
We'll need to play catch-up at some point in time. That's something that we've done before.
If you don't operate on people, things get worse. If you can't see them in the emergency department, things get worse.
The AMA has come up with a 15-point plan it says can fix the problem and wants to see the government increase its $1.9 billion healthcare spend in next month's budget. Nathan Brooks for 10 News First.